feel so good out here. I really wanted to make a video, but I doubt y'all can hear me. It's so pretty out here, y'all. Y'all probably still hear the wind.
Oh!
But it ain't cold. I feel good. But for real, I wanted to make a quick video about Ethereum and one of the things that I did when I first, well, not even just Ethereum, cryptos in general. He gonna tear his finger up. But when I first started investing, one of the things that I did that kind of messed myself up was when I saw it going down, I got scared. But so many people was telling me like, it's dropping, you're gonna lose your money and da da da. And now y'all, I've been researching this. I know this stuff for myself, but under pressure, I still got scared and pulled my money. And that's a no-no when you've been researching and watching it and you know the inclines and you know the supports and you know how, you know, watching the chart and how it goes. So my biggest mistake was pulling my money and then having to reinvest at a higher margin. I still feel bad for doing that, but I mean, it's still good to get in now. Anytime, just as long as you start, but don't listen to like media when they tell you that, oh, it's gonna crash and this, that, and the other, because there are a certain number of coins out there for each crypto. And of course, if the prices are going up and the coins are becoming more scarce, the bulls or the big investors are gonna want people to pull out so that they can buy more. So if you can't go mine the coins, then we have to work with what we got, unless someone knows how to mine them or they gonna mine some more. So of course they're gonna try to get all of us to pull out and pull back so it can be a drawback or a decrease so that they can buy in more at a lower, you know, a lower margin. Because I've been watching Raul Powell, I think that's how you say his name, but I've watched him on a couple of predictions, and he did predict that Ethereum is going to hit 10K this year, possibly 27K. And he has not been wrong about his predictions. So I'm just, you know, researching and going along as you should research too. But don't get scared. Like, investing isn't a short-term thing. Investments are long-term, you know. You have long-term goals when you invest the money because it don't happen overnight. So if you just want to make a quick dollar, you should go into day trading. Research it. Day trade. Some people say they lose a lot of money day trading, and I think that's because it's kind of more difficult because you have to sit there and watch it. You have to have time to day trade. Investing is a little more because you're looking at the long term. You know, you can, the amount or the cost can go up and down. You have some some areas to play with or whatever. So it's more, to me, I like to do it that way, long term, because I want to be wealthy. You know, I want to leave something for my kids. I want to get to a point to where when I do get ready to retire, I can retire and comfortably. Because when you are self-employed or don't work full-time or don't have a 401k and all that stuff, you don't get retirement. But yeah, some other things besides investing into stocks and cryptocurrencies that I've done is I have gotten us mutual funds. You started off, put about 500 in there, and then you wait 7 years or however many years you choose, and you know, you gain your money. This month. It was that ugly. So yeah, that's another way, y'all. And then starting a business. So But yeah, I'll talk about that more. I just wanted to let y'all know not to be scared and don't pull your money out too early. Man, leave me alone. But don't pull your money out too early because it's a drop, because it has to, when they incline like that so fast, it's gonna be a little drawback. So don't get scared and pull your money out, y'all. Just go by your best judgment. Don't go off of what anybody else said. The most important thing to do is to read your charts, learn your cycles, because history does not necessarily repeat itself, but it does reflect itself. But I know it's a lot of wind in this. I'm gonna try to cut it out, but I will see you guys in the next video, because I'm gonna go ride my skateboard.